Hello and a very good evening. You're watching the news tonight on Rajya Sabha Television with me, Frank Pereira. Here are the headlines. Both houses of parliament adjourned over the demonetization row. Opposition members demand Prime Minister's presence in the house for debate in the Rajya Sabha. Government modifies rules of the demonetization drive, says families will now be able to withdraw 2.5 lakh rupees for weddings, while farmers can withdraw 25,000 rupees per week. Exchange of old currency notes at banks reduced to 2,000 rupees per person from November 18th. Cash crunch triggers more problems for people. Banks struggle to manage rush of people. Small businesses are the worst hit. Many daily wage labourers say they are jobless. In Syria, 84 people killed in fresh government air raids on rebel-held areas near Aleppo. Medical facilities damaged. Many residential buildings flattened in bombing. Well, the demonetization issue rocked the upper house on Thursday as a united opposition pressed for Prime Minister Narendra Modi's presence in the house. The government, however, stood its ground and defended the decision, instead hitting out at the opposition. As the situation escalated, the proceedings of the house were disrupted repeatedly, leading to several adjournments through the day.
Opposition parties joined ranks in demanding a response from Prime Minister Narendra Modi on the hardships caused to people by the demonetization move. Zero Hour was derailed as the Congress, TMC and BSP raised the pitch against the Prime Minister and rushed into the well of the House. Meanwhile, AIADMK members also marched into the well, demanding constitution of the Kaveri Management Board.
No! What is...
Question hour was also paralysed as opposition members pressed for the Prime Minister's presence in the House. Repeated pleas by the chair to allow the House to function went unheeded. As the protests sharpened, the chair first adjourned the House till 12:30, then till 2 p.m.
House is adjourned till 2 p.m.
The stalemate continued even in the post-lunch session. The Congress accused the government of burdening the public with an ill-prepared policy. Meanwhile, the government refuted all allegations and lashed out at the opposition, clarifying that the demonetization decision will not be revoked. The chair urged the protesting members to discuss and deliberate the issue, but in vain. Sharp verbal exchanges were witnessed between the opposition and the treasury benches. With no signs of reconciliation, the chair first adjourned the house till 3 p.m., then till Friday.
Then I adjourned the house up to 3 p.m.
With inputs from Vishal Dhaya, Kriti Mishra, Rajya Sabha TV.
Meanwhile, protests by opposition parties forced the adjournment of the lower house as well. Opposition leaders demanded a discussion on demonetization under a rule that allows voting, a demand not acceptable to the government. As vociferous protests continued, the speaker adjourned the house for the day.
No legislative business could be transacted in Lok Sabha on day two of the winter session, as a united opposition demanded a debate on demonetization under Rule 56, which entails voting. Opposition leaders said they wanted to discuss the hardships being faced by people and the economic disruption caused by the government due to the currency ban.
हम सबका कहना एक ही है कि रूल 56 के तहत एडजर्नमेंट मोशन अगर चर्चा में ली गई तो पूरा सदन उसमें भाग भी लेगा और वोटिंग भी होगी कौन किधर है ये भी मालूम होगा दूसरी चीज रूल 193 में सिर्फ चर्चा करके आपको छोड़ देंगे
asked us to go for a discussion under rule 193.
Yes.
But the problem is we are in a mood to censor the government under an adjournment motion.
Yes.
So we request yourself that let government come up on the issue and have a...
That vote. I have
Madam, today's situation is different.
इससे गरीबों को
हारी तबाही हुई है, बर्बादी हुई है, बिना परिस्थिति एवं परिणाम का आकलन किया गया और व्यवहारिक निर्णय लिया गया।
The government expressed willingness to debate demonetization under Rule 193, which does not entail voting.
हम इतना ही चाहते हैं, यानी इस सदन से, ये महापंचायत से दो सुर नहीं निकले, इसलिए 193 के ऊपर चर्चा होना चाहिए। चर्चा करने के लिए हम तैयार हैं, कितना भी चर्चा करें, और भारत सरकार को वो सुझाव भी दे त्रासदी मिटाने के लिए, दिक्कत मिटाने के लिए क्या करना चाहिए।
However, with opposition parties refusing to budge, Speaker Sumitra Mahajan adjourned the House till Friday.
To meet again tomorrow at 11 AM.
Ravindra Sharan's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, as cash-strapped people continue to throng banks and ATMs across the country, the government today sought to ease the norms for farmers, traders and families with impending weddings. The cash withdrawal limit for wedding purposes has been raised to 2.5 lakhs per family, while farmers can now withdraw 50,000 rupees a week. This has been done to ease the hardships being faced by families and also to ensure a smooth sowing season ahead. Prime Minister Narendra Modi himself reviewed the demonetization exercise today. Here's more.
In a bid to tide over the chaos triggered by its surprise demonetization move, the government announced several new measures on Thursday. The move is aimed at providing much-needed relief to farmers, traders and families with impending weddings.
For wedding ceremonies which are going on, up to 2.5 lakh rupees will be permitted to be drawn from the bank account. We are also at the commencement of the Rabi season. So therefore, to ensure the proper that the sowing takes place properly, it has been decided therefore by the government to permit the farmers to draw up to rupees 25,000 rupees per week against the crop loans sanctioned and accredited to their accounts.
As per the new guidelines, families can withdraw 2.5 lakh rupees in one go for weddings. This withdrawal, however, can be made only from one account based on self-declaration. Farmers can withdraw up to 25,000 rupees a week against loans sanctioned to them to buy seeds and fertilizers and credited to their accounts. 25,000 a week can be drawn from payment that farmers receive for agricultural produce in the form of cheques, taking the total cash withdrawal limit for farmers from KYC-compliant bank accounts to 50,000 rupees per week. The time limit for the payment of insurance premium on crop loan has also been extended by 15 days. Traders in vegetable wholesale markets can withdraw 50,000 rupees a week to pay for expenses like daily wages. Central government employees up to Group C categories have been permitted to withdraw 10,000 rupees in cash against their November salary. The announcement evoked mixed reactions among people.
जो फैसला आया वो मोदी ने बहुत बड़ा काम किया और हम लोग को बहुत बड़ी बड़ी राहत हो गई और मेरे घर में 3 दिन शादी है, अब अच्छे से निपटारा हो जाएगा।
नोटबंदी से बहुत बड़ा प्रभाव पड़ा है, बहुत परेशानी बढ़ी है, लेकिन इसका परिणाम अच्छा है, इसलिए हम लोगों को संतोष है।
2.5 लाख में कुछ बनेगा शादी का, कोई फायदा नहीं है। अब पैलेस की बुकिंग लगा लो 4 लाख है, फिर गहने शादी खर्चा, कोई फायदा नहीं 2.5 लाख कम से।
Opposition leaders also seemed unimpressed.
आप और मैं 2.5 लाख में कर सकते हैं, आज साधारण आप 2.5 लाख में क्या आता है? 2.5 लाख में कौन सी शादी हो जाती है? कितने लोग आ जाते हैं? प्रधानमंत्री जी को मालूम नहीं है कि 2.5 लाख में आज शादी होती है?
इसका मतलब क्या है गाइडलाइन का? ये तो खेल रहे हो आप, लोगों की जज्बात से खेल रहे हो और इस तरीके की हमला जो हो रही है उनके रोजमर्रे की जिंदगी में, जो बड़े हैं आपके काले धन वाले हैं वो सब, उनको तो जो है राहत पहले से दे चुके हैं।
ये सिर्फ प्लास्टिक मनी और क्रेडिट कार्ड से धंधा नहीं चलता। अच्छा, बहुत असुविधा हो रहा है, बेबी फूड हो के असुविधा हो रहा है, दवाई की असुविधा हो रहा है, सरकार में ये एयर कंडीशन रूम में बैठ के कुछ नहीं होने वाला, जाओ देखो क्या हो रहा है बाहर में।
The government, however, maintains that the move will consequently lead to decongesting the snaking queues outside banks and ATMs across India. With inputs from Panchanand Mishra, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal and his West Bengal counterpart Mamata Banerjee addressed a rally against demonetization in the national capital on Thursday. Targeting the Prime Minister, Mamata Banerjee gave an ultimatum to the government to withdraw the scheme in the next 3 days. Both the leaders also led a protest at the RBI headquarters in Delhi.
Chief Ministers Mamata Banerjee and Arvind Kejriwal outside the Reserve Bank of India in the national capital, terming the demonetization move and the problems arising from it a financial crisis, the two said they were at RBI to talk to the people.
खाली एक ही जानकारी हमको चाहिए हिंदुस्तान भर कि जितना डिमांड है, जितना नोट लोगों का काम पे जो डिमांड है, वो नोट अवेलेबल है कि नहीं?
Earlier, the two leaders held a rally at Delhi's biggest vegetable and fruits wholesale market, Azadpur, where they alleged that demonetization would take the country back 100 years. Banerjee and Kejriwal have given the government 3 days to roll back the decision.
Aaj 9 din ho gaya hai. 25,000 crore agar GDP loss hota hai, to 9 din mein kitna hua? 2,25,000 crore ka GDP loss ho gaya hai.
Calling the protest a fight to save the country, Arvind Kejriwal alleged that demonetization was the biggest scam in independent India's history, carried out to write off the 8 lakh crore rupees of loan owed by Prime Minister Modi's corporate friends. Police was deployed in the area after slogans were raised against both leaders as they addressed the rally.
आज उन्होंने हमारा एक दिन का धंधा बंद करवा दिया. रोज हम काम करते हैं दिल्ली बंदी के अंदर. आज उनके आने से बाद हमारा काम बंद हो गया.
On Wednesday, Mamata Banerjee led a delegation of some opposition party leaders to Rashtrapati Bhavan in protest against the demonetization move. She submitted a memorandum to President Pranab Mukherjee seeking his intervention on the issue. With inputs from Anu Diwan, Bureau Report for Rajya Sabha TV.
Meanwhile, the RBI today appealed to the people not to hold currency notes, stating that there is enough supply. Banks, however, battle to manage long queues even as the centre petitioned the Supreme Court to put a stay on proceedings on demonetization in various courts.
On the ninth day of demonetization, banks across the country continued to struggle to manage the huge rush of people at various branches.
I agree with the government's decision. Only if they could make it faster so that the people don't suffer, it will be better.
अब हम पूरे दिन, अब सर पूरे दिन हम काम करेंगे या लाइनें करेंगे? मोदी ने तो कह दिया 50 दिन आप आराम कर ले सर, 50 दिन में तो हमारी लाशें पड़ जाएंगी.
At some places, police lathi-charged people who lost their cool while standing for several hours. Vegetable vendors, hawkers and small businesses that rely mostly on cash transactions were the worst hit. Several daily wage labourers said they were jobless.
इधर तो बहुत दिक्कतें हो रही है सर. हम सर रोज के 300-400 रुपए कमाने वाले सर. वही नोटें दे रहे 500 की. हम मना कर रहे तो सेठ कह रहे कि भाई हफ्ते के बाद लेना, 10 दिन के बाद लेना. हमको ही सर बहुत परेशानी हो रही है. इधर काम नहीं, मंडी के अंदर सब बैठे हुए हैं. सही
कैश आ रही है ना, आगे कैश जा रही है. आगे किसान मांगता छोटे पैसा, छोटा पैसा है नहीं. बैंकों में जमा कराए, बैंकों में रश इतना है कि वहाँ जमा ही नहीं होते पैसे. और गाड़ियों के भुगतान चाहिए, भाड़े चाहिए. 1 लाख रुपये गाड़ी का भाड़ा है तो कहाँ से ला के दें 1-1 लाख रुपये भाड़ा.
The Supreme Court agreed to hear a fresh petition by the centre that sought a stay on the proceedings before various courts except the Apex Court, as it will create confusion. Meanwhile, the RBI once again assured people, telling them not to hoard currency as there is adequate supply of notes. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Meanwhile, the NDA government's demonetization move has severely affected the working of cooperative societies. These societies in rural areas are having trouble not only in disbursing new loans but also in accepting repayments.
Cooperative societies in rural Madhya Pradesh have stopped giving out new loans and taking repayments of old ones. Even the savings bank of these societies are not able to do any transactions.
आपका बचत बैंक चलाते हैं आप? जी. तो आपके बैंक को ये अनुमति नहीं है?
जी नहीं. जी दिशा निर्देश ब्रांच से आता है, एचओ से आते हैं. हाँ. उन लोगों का आदेश निर्देश नहीं है मेरे पास कुछ.
हाँ, अभी तक आपको कोई
जी नहीं. सिर्फ बिजली बिल में आया था कि 14 नंबर तक बिल लेना है, तो हम लोग 1005 चलाए, इसके बाद बोला नहीं लेना है।
The absence of new notes with cooperative societies has also affected crop sowing. Till these societies don't give out loans, it will be difficult for farmers to buy fertilizer and seeds from the market.
बचत बैंक चलाते हैं, लेकिन हम लोग जो धान के समय खाद बीज वगैरह लिए हैं, अब अभी वह खाद मतलब धान लाकर जब हम तोलवाएं, जब बिक्री हो जाए, इसके बाद में पैसा कटौती होने के बाद पुरानी उधारी कटौती के बाद ही नया उधारी जो है हम लोगों को मिलेगा।
तो आप पुराना कर्जा नहीं चुका पाए?
हाँ, पुराना कर्जा भी नहीं चुका पाए हैं, गांव नहीं हो चुकी, अब यहाँ ला के डाल भी दें तो पैसे की अभाव के कारण जो है चेंज ना होने के कारण पैसे मिल नहीं पा रहे।
तो बैंक से आपने कोशिश नहीं की?
बैंक SBI गए थे हम, 3 दिन से चक्कर काटे, लेकिन बहुत ज्यादा लाइन लगने के कारण जो है वहाँ चेंज नहीं हो पाए।
मान लीजिए जो आदिवासी किसान है जो दूर से आया है आपके यहाँ, उसका क्या होता है?
सर वो चिल्लर ना होने के कारण उसको मटेरियल नहीं दे पा रहे हम लोग, माल नहीं देते उसको, पेमेंट वो ला नहीं पा रहा है, पुराने नोट लेके आता है, वो हम लोग लेते नहीं है यहाँ पे।
जो आपके रेगुलर ग्राहक है उनको तो उधार दे देते होंगे ना?
हाँ, रेगुलर जो जानते हैं पहचानते हैं उनको देते हैं, लेकिन फिर भी उतना ज्यादा नहीं दे पाते हैं ना हम लोग।
Even those farmers who have sold their crops are now unable to repay the cooperative societies, as all their payments came in the now illegal currency notes.
मैं भी कर्ज लिया था साहब, गन्ना का KCC बनवाया था ILM से, और ये धान के लिए भी कर्ज लिया था जिसके पैसे मेरे को पटाने थे, वो अभी हमारी लैम्स ले नहीं रही है।
क्यों नहीं ले रही है?
वो नोट बंद हो गए।
Farmers in rural areas depend on high-quality fertilizers and seeds during crop sowing season. If the situation doesn't improve soon, agricultural production could be severely affected.
Cooperative societies are the backbone of rural economy, especially in tribal areas. These cooperative societies not only provide seed and fertilizer to farmers, but these societies also provide loans to tribals and other farmers in these areas. But after the step of demonetization, the activities of these societies are almost stopped. With cameraman Vijay Kumar, this is Shyam Sundar, Rajya Sabha TV, Mandla, Madhya Pradesh.
Well, over in Uttar Pradesh, even 9 days after the announcement, Grameen banks have not made adequate arrangements for dispersing cash. Even the banking correspondents are unable to help the rural population.
Dhirendra is a resident of Sikandra Rao Tehsil. He had a good paddy crop after months of hard work. But now he is forced to hold back selling his produce despite needing the cash for rabi season.
धान की निकासी निकाल करके मैंने पैकिंग करा रखी है, लेकिन अगर मार्केट में लेके जाऊं तो वहां पे पुराने नोट देने के लिए आड़तिया तैयार हैं, इसलिए मैं जो ऐसे बेचना नहीं चाह रहा हूं, क्योंकि नया नोट मुझे मिल नहीं पा रहा है और मजदूरों की समस्या है बड़ी, जो है मैं काफी परेशान हूं, पुराने नोट जो मजदूर ले नहीं रहे।
Dhirendra has been making the rounds of banks but has to return empty-handed every time. Officials claim that rural banks are not getting enough cash.
पेमेंट जो जैसा हम पर कैश आ जाता है सप्लाई मिल जाती है, उस साथ हम पेमेंट भी करते हैं, चाहे किसी को 2,000-5,000 जैसे आपसे उसकी नीड है और उसको हम सब पेमेंट भी कर रहे हैं उसे।
The government's claim of reaching out to rural population via banking correspondence also seem to have fallen flat.
अभी तो फिर बैंक से जाना होता है कि यहाँ पे भीड़ लगी हुई है जमा करने वालों की, और निकलने वालों का भी इतना कैश भी नहीं है, उस तरह से नहीं दे पा रहे हैं फिलहाल।
As problems are compounded due to a lack of valid currency, anger over poor implementation of demonetization is also rising.
Lack of banking infrastructure in rural areas is creating delays in note exchanges. Government must take steps to speed up measures to improve note exchanges. With camera person Vijay Singh, Navikram Singh, Rajya Sabha TV, Sikandra Rao.
Moving on to other news now, Ram Gopal Yadav was reinstated into the Samajwadi Party on Thursday. Considered close to UP Chief Minister Akhilesh Yadav, Ram Gopal Yadav was expelled from the party for 6 years on October 23rd on the instructions of the party chief Mulayam Singh Yadav. Here's more.
A day after he spoke on behalf of the Samajwadi Party in the Rajya Sabha, Ram Gopal Yadav was brought back into the party fold on Thursday. Revoking his suspension, the Samajwadi Party said Ram Gopal Yadav will continue as leader of party in the Rajya Sabha. A few days ago, Samajwadi Party leader Shiv Pal Yadav had charged Ram Gopal Yadav with conniving with the BJP to weaken the party. Yadav, however, maintained that he had never worked against the SP.
धन्यवाद नेताजी को इसके लिए और मैं बहुत प्रसन्न हूँ।
सर आगे की क्या तैयारी है?
उत्तर प्रदेश जीतने की और अखिलेश को मुख्यमंत्री बनाने की।
SP General Secretary Amar Singh, who was accused of being responsible for the crisis in the party, also welcomed the move.
Decision of Mr. Mulayam Singh Yadav. There is no way that one can dispute his decision. Ram Gopal has not disputed his decision of my appointment as General Secretary. How can I dispute Mulayam Singh's decision of reinstatement of Ram Gopal Yadav?
Meanwhile, BSP Chief Mayawati took pot shots at the Samajwadi Party and claimed that the feud in the Yadav family will continue.
सपा परिवार में जो दो खाई पैदा हो गई है, इनका परिवार दो खेमे में बढ़ गया है.
Ram Gopal Yadav's reinstatement is seen as the Samajwadi Party's attempt to set its house in order before the crucial Uttar Pradesh Assembly elections.
While expelling him from the party, Shivpal had accused Ram Gopal of trying to save his skin, as his son was allegedly embroiled in Yadav Singh corruption case being probed by the CBI. Now his re-entry will add new dimension to the family feud within the Yadav clan and the Samajwadi Party. Reporting from Delhi, with cameraperson Sudipto Das, I'm Kruti Mishra for Rajya Sabha TV.
Here's a roundup of the other national news and nationwide. Former Jammu and Kashmir Governor Lieutenant General S.K. Sinha passed away on Thursday after a brief illness. He was 92. The funeral will take place on Friday. Sinha had led the first batch of Indian troops to enter Jammu and Kashmir when Pakistan raiders invaded in 1947. He also served as India's ambassador to Nepal and as the governor of Assam. Prime Minister Narendra Modi as well as National Conference leaders Farooq Abdullah and Omar Abdullah condoled his death. Two Indian fishermen on Thursday were injured in a firing by the Sri Lankan Navy when they were fishing in the Indian Ocean region. The injured fishermen are currently undergoing treatment at Jipmer Hospital in Puducherry. Meanwhile, the Sri Lankan government has released most of the Indian fishermen arrested by them in the first week of November ahead of the India-Sri Lanka officials and fishermen meet. Some parts of the Kashmir Valley on Thursday saw signs of normalcy. A few shops opened and there was movement of passenger vehicles. Banks also witnessed a heavy rush of customers. Meanwhile, the death toll in the ongoing unrest in Kashmir today rose to 86 as an elderly man injured in security forces' action against protesters 2 weeks ago succumbed to his injuries. Moving on to some international news. Now, a hospital, a blood bank and ambulances are reported to have been hit as Syrian government aircraft and artillery bombarded rebel-held eastern Aleppo. The staff of a children's hospital in the Shahr district were forced to take shelter in the basement. Activists say at least 32 people, including children, have been killed in Aleppo over the past 2 days. The airstrikes resumed on Tuesday after a three-week moratorium declared by the government's ally, Russia, ended. Activists confirmed the resumption of government airstrikes amid reports by state media of large troop deployments on several fronts ahead of a major ground assault. The UK-based Syrian Observatory, a monitoring group, said missiles fired by jets, barrel bombs dropped from helicopters and artillery targeted several areas of eastern Aleppo on Wednesday, including Shahr, Sukari, Sukur and Karam al-Baik. At least 21 people, including 5 children and an emergency worker, were killed.
It is shocking that healthcare facilities continue to be attacked in Syria. Only this year there were 126 attacks on health facilities and health workers recorded by World Health Organization and partners. We call on all parties to stop targeting health workers and hospitals because this is outrageous and this deprives civilian population from access to basic health services.
Well, Japan's prime minister is set to become the first foreign leader to meet U.S. President-elect Donald Trump since the election last week. Shinzo Abe said he wanted to build trust and work together for prosperity and world peace before leaving for his trip. The meeting in New York comes amid concern over the foreign policy direction of Tokyo's biggest ally. Trump has said Japan needs to pay more to maintain U.S. troops on its soil. He also condemned a major trade deal struck by President Obama with Japan and other Pacific Rim countries. The U.S. and Japan have been key allies since the end of World War II, when the U.S. helped Japan rebuild its economy. Abe will stop in New York on his way to an Asia-Pacific trade summit in Peru.
米国次期大統領とですね、世界の首脳に先駆けて会談を行うことができることを大変光栄に思います。トランプ大統領とは未来に向けてお互いの夢を語り合う、そういう会談をしたいと思っています。
Well, here's a roundup of the other international news and global buzz. Thousands of Malaysians are set to gather on Saturday for an anti-government rally in Kuala Lumpur to call for the ousting of Prime Minister Najib Razak in the wake of a multi-billion dollar financial scandal. The protest is organized by pro-democracy group Bersi. The group calls for the resignation of Najib to facilitate a probe into a scandal involving One Malaysia Development Berhad, One MDD, a state fund set up by the Prime Minister. Meanwhile, supporters of Najib have vowed not to let Bersi go ahead with the rally. Philippines President Rodrigo Duterte on Thursday said he might follow Russia and withdraw from the International Criminal Court. Duterte cited criticism from Western nations for a rash of killings unleashed by his war on drugs. He also described the ICC as useless and expressed frustration about the West's allegations of extrajudicial killings and its failure to understand his crackdown on narcotics. Islamic State curriculum material was found in empty classrooms in the recently recaptured Arbajia neighborhood in Mosul. Books and documents found reflected the jihadists' widespread attempts to spread their ideology to the children of the area. The books included many pictures of rifles and weapons and taught children how to spell out words like caliphate, Baghdadi and rockets. Hundreds of survivors stranded by a huge earthquake reached Christchurch by a naval ship early on Thursday. Around 450 tourists and residents from the small seaside town of Kaikoura were taken by the New Zealand Navy's multi-role vessel to Christchurch overnight. Kaikoura had been completely cut off by large landslides that covered road and rail links. New Zealand Prime Minister John Key also pledged to push emergency laws through Parliament if necessary to prop up businesses in Kaikoura. Well, moving on to some sports news now, and beginning with cricket, skipper Virat Kohli and Chiteshwar Pujara hit majestic centuries to help India take opening day honours as they reached 317 for 4 at stumps against England in the second test in Visakhapatnam on Thursday. Kohli put on a marathon 226-run stand for the third wicket with Pujara after the hosts lost their openers early to the England seamers. Kohli and Ravichandran Ashwin were at the crease when stumps were called. For England, paceman James Anderson enjoyed his return with 3 wickets, only to see the rest of the English attack face a tough time after the hosts opted to bat first. Well, that's it on this edition of the News Tonight. Good night.